everybody, and welcome to our panel discussion on citizen journalism. I have six participants on the panel here with me, and I'm going to begin with a lady to my right, Rahab. Good morning, Rahab.
Good morning.
Abdul Karim, nice to meet you again.
Yes, thank you.
Georgina, John, Evelyn, and Abel. Thank
good
you so
morning,
very
man.
Much for having you here.
Thank you.
We're going to be discussing on citizen journalism, and I'd like to go straight to that. What is citizen journalism? And I think that Abel has a better definition for us.
Thank you very much, madam. Citizen journalism, it can be described as street journalism or democratic journalism. It can also be called public journalism. Citizen journalism is another alternative of media. It's different from the professional media. Citizen journalism allows you to gather news from communities. It allows you to gather news that is not being covered. Citizen journalism, it's a very simple way of having information from the community. You can have the information from local up to the national level. That's the way I understand citizen journalism.
Great, so if I understand you well, in simpler words, it is information undiluted the way it is.
Yes, that's true.
Okay, Georgina,
do
you think you have something to add to that?
Just like you said, but the most important aspect to know about citizen journalism is how it impacts on policymakers. Because this is information that's directly in the community and has not been tempered by a third reporter. It's directly from the citizens to the government.
Okay, thank you very much for that enlightenment. And John, how do you think you can really implement citizen journalism?
I think the way you can implement citizen journalism by first enabling people to have this platform of expressing themselves, showing that democracy is something that can be gotten by society, because if you do not have democracy, then you won't find people talking about these issues. I believe that if we get so many people discussing about the different things that are going wrong, like in Uganda, and the brutality that faces the people there, you can be able to find a better platform to handle such issues.
But you're from Kenya. Would you tell us something, depending on your background as a Kenyan?
Well, when the opposition guys go to the streets or they start sharing opinions that are contrary to what the government wants, I think we are more, unlike most African countries, there's a bigger platform to express yourself. So it's also met with deaf ears, unlike the brutality that comes along with it. The brutality here is lower, but the people acting on the issues raised or the perspective shared is also something that is very wanted.
Okay, interestingly, Rahab is also from Kenya. Maybe she has a different view on how this can be implemented in your country.
I think citizen journalism can be implemented by empowering the citizen, by giving them platforms to express their views in media houses. That is increasing the viewers' part, so that they can have a larger place to, whether it's in publishers, newspapers, they can get a larger space to express their views, and that they can be put as they are, not edited, they can really put up their views out there to and communicate with other citizens on issues that are really affecting them. And also in newsrooms where viewers can be able to talk back to the media house and express what it is that is really happening on the ground.
Okay, thank you very much. And Abdul Karim, especially we are talking about using ICTs now to bring about change. How do you think we can use ICTs to implement citizen journalism and implementation in Kenya?
I think in Kenya, we want to improve or to increase the use of ICT. We need first to improve and increase the literacy level among the people in the classroom, so that they know how to process information and use certain gadgets. Because you find out that right now in Kenya, when they are here, they are actually giving out laptops to children in standard one. And so, if we want to increase from now these children to older people, then we need to increase this, let's say, adult education to those people who never had the
and we are looking at how we are going to implement this in our various countries, and taking Ghana as a case study. I'm looking at how we could use social media as a platform and then using technology as a tool to implement this, whereby now we have telephones all around, we have laptops, phones, smartphones all around, where we could just transfer information from even our various phones. We just send like maybe some news feeds, something that is really going on in your locality. Now we realize that citizen journalism is different from the mainstream journalism, where these mainstream journalism, whatever they are communicating to the citizens, are edited to suit them and then to suit the government as well. But here is the situation, we want to report something that is going on irrespective of the government's concerns. So we could do something like news highlights or news in brief or something like that, where we have a platform, we could just put it on social media, maybe Facebook or Twitter, we just tweet that this is what is happening now. You know, for instance, when we are having certain programs, we have maybe Twitter pages where we give live updates of what is going on then. For example, the Haiti issue that happened recently, where we had people sending in their videos, sending in tweets about it, that this is what is happening now. You might not be there, but you have an idea of exactly what is going on there. So this actually has to do with how you are going to make this happen, and then irrespective of what the government is also thinking, and more so, sometimes you don't even know the person in particular, so you can't even attack the person. That's looking at how the government will try to brutalize the people who are doing this. But these ones, most of the times, you could just tweet something without, you can just change the name you are using on the social media. Maybe if I'm every now, just write Abigail, and then I'll tweet that it's happening now.
So how do you make sure that the people who send out this information are the real people who have the good of the community? I mean, why do you think we need citizen journalism, and how can we check to make sure that it is information that is needed for the good of the community? It doesn't
I wanted also to elaborate a bit on the issue of democracy. You know, journalists are like the watchdogs of democracy. You know, they have the capacity, they have the potential to instill fear in people. They have the potential to remove that fear again in citizens.
Yeah, right.
So you see,
Yeah, exactly.
You see. So with the information, or if we inculcate the skills on how to utilize the citizen journalism idea, I think it will be very easy for us to gather information, to gather what is happening around in our communities, in various societies.
Mm-hmm.
I think it will be very easy.
Okay, Georgina, why do you think we need to do this?
I think I'd like to begin by bringing up an addition to how we can involve ICT in citizen journalism. I like what Ibrahim already stated about using social media and all that, but you know that there are people that are in locations where they do not have access to, you know, smartphones.
Yes.
Not because they are not available in that location, but because maybe they cannot afford to buy them. So it would be nice to come up with an app using network providers, something simple like the way we log into our, you know, scratch cards if you want to buy airtime or credit. I don't know how you create
in camera.
But yeah, it's either talk time or credit. Just how we log into, you know, buy credit would be the same way that a citizen can log in, for instance, *225#. Then, you know, a page opens up, and then, you know, the citizen can indicate the particular problems that they're facing in their communities, and possibly also have another tab where they can provide solutions to what their problems are. Then that goes directly to, you know, the policymakers.
Mm-hmm.
So it's information that has not been altered by anyone, and there's no third party involved. It's from the citizen to the
Okay, thank you. And I see
Joan,
you're itchy, you
want to
say something?
Okay. What I'd say is this, for the mainstream media, and that's why we really need citizen journalism, is that the we call them black, brown envelopes, I don't know what we call them in Cameroon, but in Kenya we call them, and it's rampant. The people in the media just get a lot of money to give information that benefits certain people. But with citizen journalism, you will not have that restraint or constraint in any aspect. People have the leeway to speak their minds out.
Mm-hmm.
And in Kenya, Kenyans on Twitter have been known to be very rampant, and they even had CNN apologize to the Kenyan government because of calling the Kenya what the terror. Yeah, so you almost feel that when the citizens are given the mandate to share their opinions, they can easily create a very big difference in the society they are in. And that's why that aspect is something that is shared by a good number of people in the country, increasing the literacy levels for them to get technology and give their opinions out. I think we can be able to change this world in a big way.
Okay, thank you. Rahab, Kenya, and why we need citizen journalism.
I think with social media, we have so many platforms where citizens can come up and express their views and go out there and be honest about what it is that they want to share. So the platforms are already there. So what is needed is more citizens coming in to participate in citizen journalism. That is the one. Now why we need citizen journalism is because we need to know what is really happening, what is really affecting that person who is somewhere in a rural village somewhere in Kenya. We need to understand the issues that are there without any interference, without anyone editing the information. We need to get that so that we can really know what it is that we need, the projects that we need to even implement, the policies that we need to change. So citizen journalism is very important, as well as also for evaluating the government and what it is that it is doing. If it says it has done this project, then if we had a citizen reporting from the other side and saying, no, this project has not even been implemented on this side, then it will create a system of checks and balances in our society for in so many ways. So I think citizen journalism is going to transform if more citizens come up to speak up.
That's an interesting idea. Abdul Karim, do you think the same way?
Yeah, I think citizen journalism is very important right now. We find that the role of media, especially, is to inform the public on what's happening, on the things that are there. But when in media, mainstream media itself, they have this the news value or the news worthiness of the story. And we find that at this moment, in these current times, we are having a lot of biased information in media, whereby the mainstream media is focusing so much on these people, the prominent people, and then they are leaving out the grassroots people, yeah, the citizens actually. Then these prominent people, they are almost having their way of manipulating the media houses, using money, using everything, just to become propaganda tools for their own means. But when this media will just, the citizens will have get opportunity to speak out their issues, and can have maybe a challenge to transmit them into the mainstream media. I think they can actually get to the notice and see what's happening there.
Thank you. Emily, you have a last word too on why we see the journalism?
Yes, finally, to conclude everything we have been saying. You know, I think that involving the people from the grassroots is a very necessary tool in order to ensure that democracy is on equal parties on equal grounds. Now, we are able to create these platforms for the ones and these grassroots to be able to involve them. We are giving them a sense of belongingness. Because when one thing that I realize is that when you talk to these people who are in these deprived areas, they feel as though they are not part of
the whole show.
So they feel that they only belong to where they are. So I think this would be a very good platform for us to involve them and then also make them feel that they are part of us. And then we are also concerned about their well-being as well.
Thank you.
I wanted also to add that with the availability of technology, with the availability of these mobile phones, it can also make citizen journalism easy. Why am I saying this? It's because now we have some applications that are developed, some applications that are being developed. These applications can also enable you to edit, to do some voiceovers, like the story maker. The story maker is one of the applications which is compatible with the Android mobile phone.
Mm-hmm.
You can upload that story maker, and you'll be able to edit. You can also do the voiceover. Then you can also put some text captions on pictures. Then it will be easy for us to implement citizen journalism.
Okay, thank you very much for that, and thank you everybody for coming. I want to thank you for enlightening us on citizen journalism. I get a guests out there, I'm sure they're also going to learn something new, and we want to adopt this as one of the solutions to the challenges we have to the current forms of governance. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.